Hallelujah. What a privilege to sit in the presence of God. ഒരു മണിക്കൂർ കഴിഞ്ഞു. Only singing and praying. Now we are going to listen from the word of God. Before that, I would like to ask you, how many of you know Pastor Steve George Uncle? Few of them know. Okay. Some of you are not knowing him. Okay. Pastor Steve George is in midst of us. He was a pastor in the North India for past several years. The last 5 years, he was serving God as a pastor in Dallas, in America. And now, we got the privilege to have the message from him. The rest of the time, Pastor, I would like to hear the rest of the time, the stage and the mic. Thank you.
Good morning. Hello, good morning. Everyone is up and awake. Are you? I wish I could sleep a bit more, you know, very honestly. I don't know your reasons, but my reason is I had a meeting at 2:30 in the morning and I could hardly sleep. I had a meeting last night, reached home late, and I could go to bed only at around 12:30 something. And then to wake up at 2 and then to do the meeting. I got some time to sleep after 6:30. But by the time, you know, it was time to get up, get ready and come. So maybe 2 hours or 1.5, 2 hours of sleep. I'm more sleepy than you are. All right? So if you sleep here, I'm going to sleep with you. So I promise you that. So, you know. Be attentive. I know it's a Saturday and definitely looking at Jeswin, I was thinking he really wanted to sleep, but maybe Ajand pushed him and he is here. So Saturday is a day when you guys want to sleep. Is that right? Yeah. And it doesn't matter however late you are up in the night doing whatever you want to do. You know what you want to do. Right? But then you don't want to wake up in the morning. And then when you wake up, it is again time for what you want to do. Anyway, time is running and, you know, it's already an hour has gone. So rest of the time, whatever is there, I'm going to talk to you. Is it okay? Will you let me talk to you? I love children. I love youngsters. My ministry has been with the youngsters for many, many years. And we serve the Lord in northern part of India, Gurgaon, if you have heard of. Gurgaon is where Jaswin's older brother was there. He did his studies in Gurgaon, MIT University, a wonderful university. You know, if you are planning, it's a wonderful university to choose. But the sad thing is we are not there. So when Joshin came, we were there and we had a wonderful time. He has such a nice young man. All right. So what do you want to hear? What should I talk to you? I have no idea. If you tell me, I'll talk to you. What should I talk? Story? What story? Once in a long time back in a jungle, there were two lions. That's what you want to hear? Or what do you want to hear? Jesus? You every day you hear about Jesus. Let's do something else. I'll tell a story about Sajeev uncle. Do you want to hear? I have a lot of stories about him. Okay, let me not do that. How many of you have your notebooks or paper or pen with you? Do you have? See, I won't blame you, you know. That's fine. I was just like you guys. So I won't blame you if you don't have. We can ask somebody to help you with a paper or a pen. That'll be great. Please, Sajeev Chah, can you? A small piece of paper and a pen. Whoever can write. And all of you, even... I want everybody. Are you the Sunday school teachers here? I don't know. All of you? All right. So maybe you can also get a piece of paper and a pen. And we are going to do some exercise. Everybody. All right. Listen to me now. Okay, now listen to me. Listen to me. All right. So what we're going to do is, how many of you have opinions about you? What do you think about you? You don't know what is opinion? You know onion? You know onion? Onion? Ulli? It's an older brother is opinion. Okay? All right. So, what do you think about yourself? That is what my question is. So, the first thing that you're going to do is, the papers that you have, write five things that you think about yourself or you have an opinion about you. What do you think about yourself? Five. Don't look at each other's sheets. You have to write. Don't write what the other girl is writing or the other boy is writing. If the other one writes, I'm a naughty boy, don't write the same thing. All right? So, what do you think about yourself? See, all these boys are looking. So, this is what you do in your exams also? Right, write. What do you know how to write? You don't have a pen? Ee kunjungalukku pena pennu kodute. All right, everybody who got a pen or if you got hold of a paper and a pen, please write. What do you think about yourself? Your opinion about you? Better. I have to move fast, so please write fast. Do you want to write? You don't want to write? Five things that you think about yourself. Irdiyo. From home? I don't know. What do you think about yourself? Or what is the opinion that you have about yourself? Pettan eludhu. See? Could you write five things about you? It's already 5 minutes gone. And you don't have five things to write about you in 5 minutes? Oh, look at you. All right. That's okay. You can copy. Doesn't matter. Huh? You're done? Very good. Okay. So that's your opinion. Girls, are you done? Boys? Can I come to you and look what you have written? See, people are still looking at blank sheets. Better there. Done? Very good. All right. Second thing. This is your opinion. What do you think others think about you? Here you go. Five. What do you think others think about you? Here you go. Others means your parents, your pastor, your friends, your siblings. Your teachers, you can write so many, many things I know. Yeah, Justin has to write it clearly because I'm going to read your paper here. Yeah, I'm just kidding. Did you write five things that others think about you? The opinion of others about you. Uh, കഴിഞ്ഞോ കഴിഞ്ഞോ, പെട്ടെന്ന് എഴുതിക്കേ, പെട്ടെന്ന് എഴുതേ, ഫാസ്റ്റ് ഫാസ്റ്റ്. ദീസ് ആർ നോട്ട് ഡിഫിക്കൾട്ട് തിങ്സ്. If you don't know what others are thinking about you, then you should never have any complaints. Avul adu paranju, avan adu paranju. You understand what I'm trying to say? Those are the things what others are thinking about you. Yeah. That you think others are thinking about you. You're done? Kaniyo. എൻ്റെ സ്കൂൾ ടീച്ചേഴ്സ് ഒന്നും എഴുതുന്നില്ലേ? ഓൾറൈറ്റ് ഗൈസ്, ഡിഡ് യു റൈറ്റ്? Good. Others, what others think about you? Eh? Enna mone? Done? Nobody thinks anything about you? No? Uh-oh. Do you know what I think about you? You didn't ask me. Now why should I tell you? All right. Are you done? All right. Now, listen. I see so many blank papers and all that, but I'm going to check it, what you have written. Now, finally, what is the first thing that we wrote? Opinion about yourself. Second thing, opinion about others. Now, finally, what do you think God thinks about you? ഒന്ന് എഴുതിക്കേ. ആ, ഗോഡ് റിയലി തിങ്സ് അബൌട്ട് മീ? ഐ ഡിഡ് നോ ദാറ്റ്. വാട്ട് ഡു തിങ്ക് ഗോഡ് തിങ്സ് അബൌട്ട് യു? ഗോഡ്സ് ഒപ്പീനിയൻ അബൌട്ട് യു? റിയലി യു ഡോണ്ട് നോ വാട്ട് ഗോഡ് തിങ്സ് അബൌട്ട് യു? ഐ ക്യാൻ ടെൽ യു ഹൺഡ്രഡ്സ് ഓഫ് തിങ്സ് ദാറ്റ് ഗോഡ് തിങ്സ് അബൌട്ട് മീ. ഫോർ എക്സാമ്പിൾ, എഴുതിയോ? ഡിഡ് യു റൈറ്റ്? ഡിഡ് യു റൈറ്റ്? എഴുതുവാണോ? ഓക്കെ. ഡിഡ് യു റൈറ്റ്? ഡിഡ് യു റൈറ്റ്? യു തിങ്ക്, ഡിഡ് യു റൈറ്റ് വാട്ട് ഗോഡ് തിങ്സ് അബൌട്ട് യു? യു ഓൾറെഡി റോഡ്. വാവ്, ജീനിയസ്. മക്കളെ, did you write what God thinks about you? Don't know what God thinks about you? Very good. No way. All right. Okay, done. Did any one of you write? No? Not for you? Okay. ഇസ്മാ എഴുതിയോ? ജസ്വിൻ, യു ആർ ഡൺ? എഫ്രൈം, യു ആർ ഡൺ? നോ, യു സ്റ്റിൽ തിങ്കിങ്? ഓൾറൈറ്റ്, ഐ തിങ്ക് ഇറ്റ്സ് ഇനഫ് ടൈം. നൗ ലുക്ക് അറ്റ് മീ, ലുക്ക് അറ്റ് മീ, ലുക്ക് ഹിയർ. Almost done? Okay, Mane, you take your time, right? All right, now listen. These three things we did. First thing, what? My opinion about myself. Do you have an opinion about yourself? Do you? Tell me one thing. Whom should I ask? Whom should I ask? Okay, tell me, what do you think? The first opinion about yourself. You? You love playing with your brother? Okay. He doesn't have a brother? Okay, he has a friend. That's okay, that's fine. Yeah, we all are his brothers, so don't worry about it. Okay, one of you girls here, what do you think? One opinion about you? Yeah. Oh, avada ketti idanga parnaya. Did you write that? All right. So is that the opinion about you? What did you write? Jasmine, did you write? Huh? Yeah, that's good. See, that's the opinion. That's the opinion. That's good. Anyone, girls here? Anyone wrote that you are lovable? Did any boy tell you that you are lovable? No? Oh. See, boys are hrudayam thodunavarege. Right. Okay. Second thing, what others think about you? Does it matter? Does it matter what others think about you? It does. If you think it doesn't matter, it matters to you. I'll talk about it. What do you think? Can somebody tell me what, Ephraim, what did you write? Did you write at all? Do you pass all your exams? All right. Did you write? What did you write? What others think about you? Just tell me one thing. That's what people say about you? You are loud and persistent? Oh, good. That's actually a very good opinion if people are talking there about you. Yes, Jasmine. I too have the same opinion. Right. What did you, one of you, yeah. What do you think others think about you? You did not write? Why? You don't like it? Okay. Yeah. Yeah. You're naughty? Oh, really? By the looks, you don't seem to be, though. Yeah. Uh-huh. Deceptive, right? Right. Somebody here, yeah. Mane parane. Did you write anything? Uh-huh. You, yeah. Yeah. You're silent? That's what other thing? You really think so? On the choice and okay. All right. What did you write? You're sad all the time? But you look so happy. What did you write? You're talented? That's what are the things about you? Okay, see. Now, the most important thing, what God thinks about you. How many of you wrote that? Let me see your hands. You know, opinions about you, okay, what do you think, what others think, and what God thinks. What did you write? What God thinks about you? What? So that God, that is what God thinks about you? Oh, good. I like that. He's confident about himself. That is very good. Yes. That is one thing I would have loved to hear. Thank you. Wonderfully made. Very good. What else? Yes. God will bless you. That is what God thinks about you. Okay, Mane. God will bless you. Yeah. You're with him always. Now with your parents. Okay, good. Yeah. God loves you. Okay. Some senior guys here. What God thinks about you? Yeah. He understands your inner feelings. So what is it? So what kind of feelings is that? Platonic? Romantic? What feelings God understands? All the feelings? Yeah, the right? Yeah. Yeah, Jasmine. You didn't write? Okay. Ephraim, did you write? No. Anyone of you, did you write anything? What God thinks about you? Any boys here? What do you think God thinks about you? Yamane. Go ahead. Nyane. Devendra Jindikende. What is God thinking about you? What do you think? All right, no problem. Now pay attention. Just look at it. We almost spent 10, 15 minutes writing about this. You really had an opinion about you? Think about it. You check your papers, you will understand. I just had one or two that could be put in the category of opinions. Opinion, right? Second thing, what others think about you. When you talk, what others think about you matters to you so much. It influences you a lot. It impacts your life a lot. But when it is asked to you what others think about you, you have no idea. You had any idea? Yeah, exactly. But is it important for you to know what others think about you? It may be important. But should it matter to you? Not really. Right? What you think about you gives you a perspective about you. Who you are. What you are. What you can do, what is your capabilities and all that. What others think about you defines nothing. Hello. Did you hear me? What others think about you defines nothing. They can say you are naughty. The same way somebody else can say you are good. So when it comes to you about opinions from others, it varies. It changes. Keep changing. Your parents will say, he is like that. He is this and that. But when you go out, some people may have different opinion. So does it matter? It matters in a way, but actually not. It doesn't carry too much of weightage, right? The most important thing, what God thinks about you. Why? What should matter in your life? Tell me. Your opinion about you matters a lot. That's right. What others think about you, I said it doesn't define anything. But what matters and what defines your life the most is what God thinks about you. All right? Now, if you read the book of Genesis, I'll just flip through it. I'm not going to dwell there. The book of Genesis, chapter 1 and on, you read all the passages, you will see God says after he created everything, what did God say? It is good. Are you with me? Are you with me? Makla, Jaren, just come here. I just want to pass. Shift. That I can have a way, all right? Angane, nee irikkadada kutta, innittu va. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, now it's good. All right. So, every passage after God created, what did he say? Tell me. It is good. So, you read the scriptures, you will understand. After God made man and woman, Adam and Eve, and after he created everything when the creation was done, it is only after he created Adam and Eve, what did God say? It is very good. It is very good. All right? Now, Psalms 139, as one of the youngsters said here, when you were in your mother's womb, the word of God says you were wonderfully and beautifully made. Right? You were, woven together. You were put together. You were knit together in your mother's womb. So what was God doing actually? He was putting you together in your mother's womb. We have to believe that. Can you imagine? I don't want to get into the details. Many of you, would understand, but the kids here, so they might not understand what I'm trying to say. So let me not get into the details. But can you just imagine, you being formed in your mother's womb out of, the way, the beautiful way it is created? It's just amazing. You need to know the way you are created to understand who you actually are. But just imagine Even after the word of God teaches us that you are wonderfully, beautifully made, we get discouraged by hearing what others talk about us. Don't we? Don't we? The moment we are not good in our studies, mandana. Have you heard that? And it discourages you. Right? I grew up in North India. And in my school, there were all these Punjabis, fair, tall guys, you know. And you know what they would call me? There was a Sardar guy. He was very fair. We were very close friends. But whenever we picked up a fight, he would call me Kallu. You know the meaning of Kallu? And it really irritated me. He will call me Blackie. Yeah. One wonders what is wrong with this Sardar. Right? But that is what he would say. And did it bother me? Actually not, but it did. So what we hear from others, it matters a lot. You may be fat, you may be tall, you may have dark shade, I do not know, right? You may not be that tall, right? You may not be that intelligent, you may not be that good looking in your opinion, in others' opinion. But when God looks at you, what does God say? Hello. So what should be important for you? What should be important for you? What God is talking about you. What God is intending to say about you. See, our problem is we have our opinion and we live in a world of disappointments and frustrations. We hear what others talk about you and we go into a shell of our own which we don't want to break. We seldom wait to hear what God wants to talk to us. The moment you understand what God says about you, talks about you, the whole perspective is going to change. All right? So youngsters, the most important thing in your life is what God talks about you, what God says about you. World may have opinions about you. World may have hundreds of things to talk about you, looking at what you are, the outward expressions of whatever you do. How does, this little one said she is naughty. I cannot even figure out that she is naughty. Still not. Right? How does people say that she is naughty? Maybe by the actions or stuff that she does, right? Is there any other way? If she keeps standing like that, will anybody say she is naughty? How do you say that she is naughty? Or does anybody say that, actually? You do? So you are. Oh, brother? What other witness do you need? Right. So how do you know that, how does that opinion come? By the actions that you do, by the things that you do. You understand? So the world around you makes an opinion about you depending on what you do. Right? But how does God make an opinion about you? He is your creator. He made you. What no one else knows about you, He knows. You understand what I'm trying to say? What no one can ever comprehend about you is what God thinks about you. So what should matter to you? Huh? See, don't live with opinions that people have concerning you. Don't live with those words that hurts your inner soul and, gets you into a world of your own. Don't live with that. Every moment, youngsters, teenagers, listen to me. You have a God who looks at you and God says, you are beautiful. You are good. Does it matter to you? It doesn't matter to you? If God says you're actually a good-looking girl, why did you say no? So, if God says you are beautiful, you are good. And if someone else is talking something about you, what should matter to you? I want to hear that. Are you sure? What God is talking about you, that is what should matter to you. Most important thing. All right? Why do I say that? Why what God says should be important to you? Because He is your creator. He is the one who made you. Irrespective of, you know, the color and the race and the ethne or whatever you say, you may have. When God looks at you, you are a child of God. And God looking at you says, you are good. You are beautiful. Amen. Amen. Break out of your shell where you are. You know, you have brought yourself in hearing those discouraging words which people have talked about you. Those painful words that you have heard people talking about you. Good for nothing. Fool. You know, I don't want to use those words, you know, which would have come out of people's mouth, which would have really disturbed you, which would have distracted you, discouraged you as you were growing. The comparisons people have made about you. I can tell you so many comparisons were made about me. Right? I can tell you how people, you know, talked about me. But I always look to God, what God is talking about me. That is the most important thing. You know, there were hurts in my heart. I've heard people have different opinions. One day I will hear one thing, the other day I will hear something else. And then the next day, next month, coming years, I would hear so many hundreds of opinions that people had. Does it influence you? It does. It hurts you. Deep inside your heart, you keep those things, right? The remorseful thoughts that get into your heart, you live with it. And your personality develops according to the opinions that you hear from people. Somebody said you are not good, and you live with that. Somebody said you are not good looking, and you live with that. Somebody said you are not intelligent enough, and you live with that. You heard your people say, oh, avale kando, avale midikiya, and you live with that, I'm not midiki. Somebody said, you know, oh, nee eppidum orakkama, onninum kollathilla, and you start living with that jargon that, you know, I'm good for nain, onninum kollathilla. Come out of that this morning. When God looks at you, that is the most important thing. When God looks at you, He says, yes, there is something good. Right? Something good can come out of you. You are beautiful. You are wonderful is what God thinks about you. Right? All right? People may have different opinions. The most important thing is what God thinks about you. Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 11. What does it say? Don't turn to your Bibles. Tell me the word. Jeremiah, every youngster should know this word. Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 11. What does it say? For I know the plans that I have for you. Plans not to harm you. Right? Now listen. Every other person that you meet, you may think they have a plan to harm you, disgrace you, disappoint you. But your God has a plan to do what? To do what? Come on. Now speak. What is the plan of God? To give you a future. You can see the word, right? Huh? To give you a future and a hope. That is the plan of God. Now let me ask you. Whose plan is going to succeed? If God has a plan. Good morning. If God has a plan. And the world has a plan. Whose plan is going to succeed? I promise you, I'm also very sleepy. So if you sleep, I'm going to, please. Okay. Right? So whose plan is going to succeed? Are you sure? So if you're sure that God's plan is going to succeed, should you be worried what you're going to do? What you should do? You know, when we were small, when we were kids, you know, when something difficult would come, what would we do? We will run and get hold of our parents' hands. Why? Why? Why would you do that? No, Mane. I'm saying, when we were kids, when you are kids, when I was a kid, or when some of us were kids, when there was a problem, we saw that this is near difficult, We would run and get hold of our parents' hands. Why? Because we knew that they will save us. They will cross us. They will take us over. Right? We were confident that what we were not able to do, who can do? Who can do? God can do it for, and parents can do it for us. You understand? So the moment you know that this is difficult for you, what do you do? What do you do? Run to God and go get hold of his hand. What do you do? The moment you think it is difficult, you run into your room. And God knows what happens in that room. In that small room, all by yourself, lonely, with your gadgets, with your phones, with your iPads, with your system. A lot of things that can happen. Beautiful things can come out of the system. Right? Ugly and filthy and, tempting and all those things can come out in the small, dark corner of your room. Do you have a room like that in your house, in your home? You don't have? Right? In America, every other kid has a room of their own. And my church, one of the church family, when I started pastoring the church, one of the aunties came and said, "Pastor, I have a problem. You need to visit our home. Our boy, he is a worship leader. He sings beautifully, does everything good. And one fine day, she says, you need to visit our home." He's very good friends with the boy. He's a lead guitarist in the church. So in the church, he's very good. So, the Achayan says, "You have to visit our home. There is a problem." So I went to their home and said, that is his room. That is our son's room. So I went up to the room and I'm standing right in front of the door. And you know what is it written? Enter in your own risk. All right? Enter in your own risk. I'm scared. What is it? Do you have a room like that? I'll come to that. The time is really, I wish the clock turns back a little bit. So, do we have youngsters, young ones, the upper strata of the young ones? Do you have a room like that? All the kids are saying no. All these guys are keeping quiet. So that means there is something. Right? These kids, of course, they might be still sleeping with their moms and dads. Right? How about you? No? You're grown up? All right, very good. That's nice. Do you have a room of your own? What do you do in your room? Now tell me. Listen. Have you heard anybody becoming a doctor by playing right in front of the screen the whole day and becoming a doctor? Have you heard about, if you meet somebody like that, please give my number or let him know that I want to meet that person, because I also want to become a doctor playing the whole day. Right? You the whole day you engage yourself in something that is not useful. Right? This is a time for you to acquire, accumulate, get as much as you can, and make a future for yourself. Now, listen, kids. Do you know why are you in this country? Kedilla. Onnum kooda orakkam parane. I wish your parents were here to hear this. They would have been happy. Right? Why are you in this country? Are you sure? Did you come off your own? One day you decided, enough of India, I need to go to Qatar. Did you decide that? Yeah. So who brought you to Qatar? Don't tell me God. Of course God. I know. Don't spiritualize everything, okay? Yeah, there's some foundations to everything. So why are you here? How many of you think your parents, when they were growing up in school and college, they had a WhatsApp and they had a phone and gadgets and they were playing the whole day, chatting and cheating and doing everything. And then finally they, Devar said, oh, you did well with your gadget things, so we award you a nursing degree, an engineering degree, so go to Qatar and live there and, you know, get married and produce children and bring the children up in that country. Hello. How did it happen? How did it happen? Your parents worked hard. I'm telling you. They worked hard. They studied. They went to, you know, it was difficult. Do you know it was difficult for our parents? It was difficult for them. It was not easy. When they were growing up, a good meal was a dream for them. You know, thank God for the opportunities that you have. Thank God for the makale and the mook and the idea in the samsarikkunnu. Listen to me. Right? It was difficult for them. A good meal, you know, some of us, you know, we sulk, you know, we complain. Indanda chicken illathe, indanda mutton illathe. You know, our parents would smell mutton at somebody else's house and eat the food. There were days like that, I'm telling you. It's not jokes. I'm telling you the truth. Thank God, God has given you parents who are earning good enough to give you what you want. Why are they providing everything to you? To see a good future from you, in you. But are you working towards it? If you spend the whole day, you know, not working hard, and then complaining the teacher, complaining the school, avadonum padipichilla, ivadonum padipikkunnilla, nothing happening, who is to be blamed? I've heard of people in India who become, you know, the IAS aspirants and the IPS and the, you know, people who sit for the CAR exams and all. They study for 19, 20 hours a day. Don't even sleep, some of them. They spend that much time. I have a friend who is was from Chengannur, but now he's shifted to Trivandrum, you know, living in a secluded place. He and his wife, they're preparing themselves for IAS exam. They don't talk to anyone. So I think once in a while he'll send a text saying, Pastor, please keep us in prayer. That's all what I hear from him. They're preparing themselves away from home. All the, you know, disturbances. What are they doing? 24/7 they are studying. They're working hard. Are you listening to what I'm saying? This is a time when you can build your future. This is a time when you have the best things in life to build yourself up. But what do we do? What do we do? Namukku orakkam ellarkum priyama alle. Even I love sleeping, I'm telling you. You know? But what about your education days? When I was in school, I remember I would come back from school and the first thing I would do is my bag would go flying one way, my shoes will go flying one way, and only one thing I would do is pick up the cricket bat, run to the ground to play. Right? Now what do? We come back home and we check the pocket. Maybe your phone is in the pocket or the drawer or somewhere else. The first thing that you want is what? You may be hungry, you didn't eat anything. Even the tiffin box that you took to the school, you brought it back. But much more than that, what is your desire? What is your desire? There's one good thing, right? That phone. Idungondangana endengilum cheyan pattumo? Can this phone give you a future? So why do we spend so much time with your phone? Gadgets, can it give life to you? Can it build a future for you? See, everything should be in order, you know. There should be a discipline. I have seen youngsters, even in church, they cannot go without the phone. Pastor is preaching, Karta, where are I? And he is here. Ding, 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 ding. The play is going on, you know. What is there? What is the good play these days? What? Tell me something. I know you don't play, but PUBG or KIMG, what is it? What? Huh? Come on, guys, tell me, honestly. What is the games you are playing these days? Supreme? Aircraft? What? Eh? Huh? What are the games? Come, I'm not trying to embarrass you. I'm just trying to prove a point. See? Girls? You just know what your brothers are doing. Yeah. You are more smarter than, you know? Anyway. Okay, enough. Thank you. Enough information for me. Right. All right. Listen. Okay. Sit properly. Yeah. Quiet. Listen. Okay. So, is your life disciplined? See, anybody who doesn't have a disciplined life, you are not going to, you know, get into those heights where you will achieve something. You sleep for 12 hours and you are thinking that you will make up something in life. No, it doesn't happen that way. You don't become a doctor and an engineer by sleeping 18 hours a day. You become that by studying, working hard for 18 hours a day. Don't complain. Work hard. Acquire knowledge. Read books. You know, get informations. Right? What you don't understand, read that again. By going back to the same thing again and again, you will learn something which will stay with you. Right? I can tell you one thing, youngsters. At this age, it all looks good. But when it, you know, once you grow up, you reach into your young adulthood and you grow into those adulthood stage, you will understand you have wasted enough time. I'm telling you. So this is a time when you should work hard, learn more, spend more time to, you know, do good in your school and college. And then, you know, when the foundation is laid properly, you will receive what the blessings, you know, from God. Let's talk about more about spiritual life. Now, there were three things that I wanted to talk, but I didn't get into it looking at the time because I don't know if I could do justice with it. Maybe I'll need one more day or few more sessions to complete what I was actually thinking could talk to you. So that is the reason I did not take it. But anyway, let me just give you a glimpse of what I wanted to talk to you. If you have your Bibles, turn to Luke's Gospel and chapter 15. You have your Bibles? All of you? Mane? Chakre? Bible on the other. Luke's Gospel. Luke Ariyam Evadayanana. Luke's Gospel, chapter 15. Are you there? Okay, everybody come to Luke's Gospel, chapter 15. Are you there? All right. Now, you're still looking? Luke comes after Revelation. Did you find it? Kittiyo? Okay. I said it right. Revelation kitti kazhinja Luke kittu enna paranjathu. Right. So you there? Luke's Gospel chapter 15? Luke 15, right. Now listen to me. There are three stories that is mentioned in the scripture. Is it? What is the first story? The lost sheep. Second story? The lost coin. Third one? Lost son? The prodigal son? I would prefer to call a lost son. Prodigal is more, you know, it's a verb. It's like what you do, the actions, you know, with whatever you do. So prodigal. So let's use lost son. Now, let me move very fast. The story about the lost sheep is that this sheep was caught in a bush and it couldn't get back. So the shepherd is coming back and searching for the sheep. And then the coin. Now, let me ask you, what is the main thing that you understand from this story? Why do you think the shepherd came looking for the sheep? Why do you think the woman is looking for the coin? And why is the father waiting for the son? Did you get me? Why did the shepherd go looking for the sheep? Why did the woman search for the coin? Why did the father wait for the son? What do you think, Jaswin? Why do you think the shepherd went looking for the sheep? Sunday school teachers? It is important. All right. It is duty. Okay. What do you think, guys? Why do you think the shepherd went looking for the sheep? Huh? He knew he would find it. What do you think? He valued the sheep. That's a good point, I'll take. Why do you think the shepherd went looking for the sheep? Okay, that's a good point. You don't know the way? Come on. Hello, hello, hello. Boys, why do you think the shepherd went looking for the sheep? Huh? Okay. Okay, girls, why do you think the shepherd came looking for the sheep? Bring back. Okay, why? Huh? Pressure. So I thought he has got blood pressure or something. Okay. He paid a price. All right. Why do you think? Why did the shepherd go looking for the sheep? Okay. I'll take that. Okay. Okay. Ephraime, nee ende valsalya putran para. Responsibility. Okay. How many of you have seen aadine kandittundo? Meh. Video kandittundo? Aadine kandittille. Naati povumbo or aadine kandittu varana. When you go to India, go to Kerala, tell your parents I want to see an aad. Right? Yeah, kumbanaad. Right. All right, listen. Aad. What, you know, there are characters about sheep. One thing, the most important thing, there are many important things. I wish, you know, I would be able to take all that up. I don't know. Let me rush through very fast. One of the things is the sheep has no idea about direction. Have you seen, you know, I don't know if some of you grew up in North India. If you grew up in North India, you will know there are, you know, there's people from Rajasthan and other places, they would have, flocks, and they would take them, the nomads, they will take these sheep, the flocks, and move around into the different parts of India, and they would be feeding them, right? All you would see is a fellow with a long stick in the front and just walking. And you will see thousands of sheep just following him. All right? And then there will be few of the guys who would be behind. But this guy who is walking in front is the main lead guy, the shepherd. And all the sheep, they just follow. Right? If the shepherd turns to the right, the sheep will go right. Now listen carefully. The moment a sheep turns to the right, it is not the shepherd that the sheep is looking at. It is the next sheep that the sheep is looking at. Did you hear me? Get off. So, is sheep in the movement, the movement of the sheep depends on whom? On whom? The one who is walking in front. Manislayo? That is why you young ones, your walks are so important for the coming generation. What do you do in church? See, you think I don't understand? I understand. Okay? So, yeah. So, what do you do? What you do in church, it is important. How you behave, the way you are, young ones are watching. Achachanda kutte enikaya, that is the way. That's the way it is. whether you agree or not. Okay? So be careful what you do. Be very careful. The moment a sheep turns to the right, you know why? Because, now listen, the sheep, they have no idea about direction. They have no intelligence to understand where to go and what to do. But what are they good at? They are good at following. They will just follow. Another thing. You know why do they follow? Why do they follow? Do you know? I will tell you why. Because the sheep don't have good sight. Okay? So why do they, have you seen the sheep all together? You know, jumbled together, walking close by. And you know, they will walk in a mix, right? They walk together. So the important thing is, they will follow the shepherd, but they are so dependent on the one who is leading them. Another thing, the sheep, they don't have good sight. They cannot see far. What is going to come, what is going to happen, they don't know. But they're completely dependent on the shepherd and the sheep in front. Another important thing that you need to know is, they are very good with smell. They can smell the shepherd. They can smell the sheep which are around. And this is what the sheep are dependent on. Right? Now listen. This sheep who is lost in the bush. Is there anybody to show direction? Can it smell? Can it see? No. Do you understand that? That is the reason the shepherd needs to come looking for it. Because by its own, it cannot find the way. By its own, it cannot smell anything. It cannot smell the shepherd. It cannot smell the other sheep around. So it's so dependent on all those circumstances for it to get back home. But none of those things are around. Right? Now listen, this is something that really encourages me. What can it do? What can it do? It can cry. In that situation, caught up in the bush, thorns around, all alone in that jungle, right? The fear of being caught up by some wild beast, you know, torn into pieces in some seconds, or in minutes, or in hours. Scared for life. He don't know. He cannot smell. He cannot hear the voice of the shepherd. If the shepherd whistles or says something, he recognizes that is something very important. He can recognize the voice of the shepherd, but in that wilderness, he cannot hear anything. All right? He cannot hear. He cannot smell. He cannot see. None of those things. But what can it do? It can cry. Right? Now, the shepherd is coming looking for the sheep. Why? The shepherd understands, unless I go looking for this guy, he's gone. If I am late, in few hours, he will be torn into pieces. If I am late, I will not be able to see him anymore. Some hours gone, if the night covers up, I won't see the sheep in the morning. Some wild beast would tore the sheep into pieces. That is why the loving shepherd, what does it do? Leaves the 99. They are together. They can take care of themselves. They can be together in the barn. But this guy, the shepherd, is coming looking for this one lost sheep. Why? Because the shepherd knows it cannot get back home of its own. Did you understand? Let me tell you something. The shepherd, when it comes looking for the sheep, he will make noises. You know, the peculiar noise that the sheep understands. He will make those whistles or noises. And the moment this sheep hears the voice, the whistle, the moment this sheep hears the steps of the shepherd, right? He will be calling the sheep. Maybe he's given a name. He will call the sheep by its name. Now, what does the sheep do? The moment it hears, You know, the footsteps of the shepherd, what does that sheep do? What does that sheep do? It would cry even more louder. Right? This is a real picture that I'm giving you. In the bush, where he cannot come out of its own, caught up real tight in those thorny bushes, when he hears that his shepherd is walking close, the moment he hears the whistle or the sound, the moment he can smell his shepherd, what does the shepherd do? What does the sheep do? He will start crying even more louder. Why? Why? So that his shepherd would hear him. Young ones, did you hear me? Whatever situation you are in, your shepherd wants to bring you out. The moment you can hear your shepherd calling your name, I want to talk to you. This growing up years, you know, you have your own ideas. You have your own thinking. We, you know, you come into that age where you're thinking all what you are doing is right. You know, we come to an age where we think our parents don't understand. They're zombies. Right? From alien from some other country. We bring up those excuses where we say, our parents, they don't understand. There is, you know, communication gap, generation gap, all the gaps. We talk about it, right? Let me ask you. You grew up in this generation. When I was growing up, you know, I didn't use a diaper. Sorry. Hello. My mom didn't change my diapers. But when your age came, you guys were using diapers. Did anyone of you change your own diaper? We talk, right? Think about it. Who did it for you? When you were growing up, you didn't even know how to change your diaper and you're talking all this big stuff that your parents don't know. Your parents exactly, your mom exactly knew when to feed you. Your mom exactly knew when to give you food. Your mom exactly knew when to put you to sleep. Eh? Have you heard? Yo, kunyayirunnappo endo sundaranayirun ippo kolam kandille. Have you heard that? Those were the days when your parent, your mom was taking care of you. Now these are the days of Elijah. These are the days of your own self. We are taking care of our own self. Orangandena samayamilla, tinnandena samayamilla, tinnandena parayamalle, kalikkandena whatever. കഴിക്കുന്നതിന് സമയമില്ല, പഠിക്കുന്നതിന് സമയമില്ല, ഒന്നിനും സമയമില്ല. എന്തിനാ സമയം എന്നറിയാമോ? സമയത്ത് പേരൻസ് കുത്തിക്കൊണ്ടിരിക്കും. എന്തോ ഈ കുത്തുന്നേ? When we were growing up, കുത്തുന്ന കാര്യം പറയുമ്പോൾ ഇറ്റ്സ് എ ഇഞ്ചക്ഷൻ ദാറ്റ് വി തോട്ട് അബൌട്ട്. റൈറ്റ്? സോ വാട്ട് ഈസ് ദി കുത്തിഫിക്കേഷൻ ദീസ് ഡേയ്സ്? വാട്ട് ഡു വി കുത്ത് ഓൾ ദ ഡേ? ഫോൺസ്? ആർ യു ഷുവർ? Think about it. Are you spending more time with this thing than God, than your parents? When is the last time you sat together and had food? When is the last time you enjoyed time talking to your parents? The best memories of me in my family is when, you know, we would sit around the table with my parent, my dad. My dad would crack jokes when we were together dining. You know that. Even now, those are the memories that I carry. Even now, he's 84 now. But even now, when we sit together on the table, those are the times that I really enjoy. Right? Ippam table onnum venda. Food inju thannere ente roomilottu valichu ketti avade konde. Why? Do you understand what I'm trying to say? Now, I have to say this. What do you do with your phones? Are you into any kind of things which the Lord will say no? Can our phones be holy? Hello? Can our phones be holy? Yes, it should be holy. It should be holy. No filthy things. Yes, I'll say what I'm trying to say. No filthy things. No, you know, inappropriate thing should come out from your phone. How many of you know You know, anybody a drug addict here? Any girls? Huh? Cocaine? Marijuana? Huh? MDM, whatever you say. Huh? Any bidi, cigarette? Boys? Any one of you? Ningaloda chodicho. Guys, any bidi, cigarette? Huh? Pure ano? Very good. I like that confidence. Are you sure? ഞാൻ മിണ്ടുന്നില്ല. ഇടയ്ക്കിടയ്ക്ക് ഉണ്ടോ അതോ വല്ലപ്പോഴും ആണോ? പിന്നെ നോ? ഇസ് ഇറ്റ് എ നോ? ഹലോ, ഇസ് ഇറ്റ് എ നോ? ഓൾറൈറ്റ്. എനിബഡി? വാട്ട് ഡു യു കോൾ ഇറ്റ്? ആൽക്കഹോൾ. താങ്ക് യു. ഏതാ ബ്രാൻഡ്? Anybody here? Girls? No? Are you? You come to Kerala, look at our girls. They are good. Any boys here? Rum, whiskey, wine? No? Wasting life, man. Don't say Pastor Uncle said it, okay? Why did I say that? We are so confident that we don't use any, you know, tobacco, cigarettes, or none of those things. We are confident. Yes, no. I heard that. We said, okay, no to alcohol. You know, kallilla, nothing, none of those things. Now, let me ask you. I don't know, maybe from 14 above, 15 above, why? 49, 8, 9, 10, 11, oru boleya. Eh? Anybody, be careful what I'm asking you. You don't have to say yes or no. But I'm asking you. You know what it is, right? Yeah. You're very smart kids. Okay, listen. Okay. Anybody here? Let me ask you. How about pornography? You don't have to know. It's okay. Have you heard calligraphy? Yeah. Yeah, it's something very different to calligraphy. Yeah. Hello. Can you confidently say it's a no? It's a sin. See, I have my wife is here, so you know whatever I'll say, she will testify to what I am saying. Over the years, I have talked to thousands of youngsters. You were here when the ICPF camp was going on. Sibi was here, right? Me and Sibi, we have ministered so many parts of India together. So I know what I'm saying. I've talked to thousands of youngsters. When you find for some things, when you say no, I know what that no means. All right? We so conveniently cover our sins with a no. But if I can look into your private life, your secret life, I'll be able to find that it is a big yes. And whether you agree with it or not, you don't have to. That's the truth. Pornography is something that has crept into the church, into the Christian circles, into the lives of the young ones. It is a sin. It will give you fun, enjoyment. It will be with you for some time, but it will destroy you. It will not take you anywhere. You don't have to, you know, you don't have to go into looking for, searching for sites and all that. It pops up. It comes your way. Right? You look for jobs. You're searching for jobs. You're looking for good university. You're looking for good education system. It never pops up. But this is something that keeps coming your way. Here it is. Take it. And out of temptation, curiosity, somewhere down the line, we just click one. There it starts. What is not yours, what you should not put your hand into, never, ever put your hand into. What you should not click, don't click. What you should not see, don't see. Right? What you should keep away from, keep away. If you are somebody who has a system which is, you know, which has a backside for every other person, be careful. Don't tell me that you are a no person. All right? Be careful. Girls and boys. It's equally binding. You know, don't think that it's just about boys. No. Girls are, you know, neck deep into it. In Kerala, I'm telling you, I'm not judging any one of you. Don't take me wrong. As a pastor, as a, you know, servant of God, I respect all of you, love you. But this is my concern that I see. Even in the US, it's no different. You know, where I was pastor, I had almost 150 plus kids in the church. That was my worry. I had parents who would come and talk to me concerning this. This is in the church. Right? You cannot grow spiritually. See, the moment your interest from church, singing, worship, things of God starts going down, you need to check your life where your interests are catching up. You need to know that. The more your interest concerning the world grows, your interest concerning God diminishes. It gets into a low. Be careful. Your phones need to be holy. Your gadgets need to be holy. I grew 6 feet tall. I didn't have a phone, thank God. I didn't have an iPhone. I had no gadgets. But I think I grew up enough, right? I got married. I got married to a beautiful girl. So you don't have to have gadgets and, you know, everybody looking. Yeah, there's my girl. Yeah. So if you think that, you know, only tech savvy, you know, technologically sound people are going to get married and you will be the smart. No, that is wrong. Don't live in that world where you think that, you know, to be known, to be somebody or a happening person, you don't have to do all those things. All right? Hello. Are you with me? Almost time for me to close. I'm not going to close. I have to talk to you. Second thing, relations. Pornography, if you are into it, make a decision. I'm not judging anybody, okay? Anybody can get into it. But if anybody can get into it, all of us can get out of it. Yes, we can. The more you cover it up, the more it is going to kill you. Right? If I go to a doctor and, you know, you are diagnosed with a disease and then you never visit the doctor, you will say, no, the doctor's what he said is wrong. You don't want the medicine, you don't want the treatment, nothing. You are living a life, you know, thinking, no, I have no sickness. The sickness which was diagnosed is going to kill you. You understand? The moment you know something is wrong, you know, the moment you understand there is something wrong, you need to come out of the cover. Blow it up. Take it off. Help will come your way. God will help you to come out of it. There is no sin that deep that my God cannot bring you out of it. All right? There is no temptations that grave that my God cannot take you out from. The thing is, we need to confess. We need to say, yes, God, I am into this rut. I need to get out of it. It is our decision. It is my decision. The moment I take that decision, the Holy Spirit your way, with you, counselor, helper, comforter, who will help you to come out of that. Right? Sinning is normal. But if you continue, you know it is sin, and if you're continuing to live with it, that is abnormal. All right? And the moment you know how to come out of it, if you're still continuing to live with it, you're killing yourself, destroying yourself. The thing is, you need to come out of it. Right? What can you do? As the sheep, you know you cannot come out of it. You can cry out loud, God, I need your help. I'm in this thorny bush. I'm in this temptation. I'm in this addiction, God. Bring me out. Take me out. The more louder you cry, you will hear your shepherd walking faster to you to help you. Right? Second thing, I'll move faster. Then you check, please give me a few more minutes. I need to talk this. About relations. This, you know, when our growing up years, we get attracted. All right. Right. Growing up years, we get attracted to boys and girls. Is it normal or abnormal? Very normal. Right? It's very normal. Okay? Can a boy and a girl can be friend? These are questions that I heard. Huh? Can be friends? Yeah. But there is limits. There are boundaries. You know, our God has created boys and girls in two different ways. Men's body, women's body, it is different. All right? So if you think, you know, the growing up years, there's something called infatuation. You know about that. I'm not going to go into it. You are attracted. You know, your attraction nowadays, I was reading a book, you know, of a psychologist. I don't remember his name. One American guy. And he was saying, this thing comes into a child, you know, from the age of 6 or 7, where he becomes possessive. He or she becomes possessive about someone, a girl or a boy. At the age of 5 or 6, നമ്മളെന്താ പറയുന്നത്? കൊച്ചു കുഞ്ഞല്ലേ. Right? Yeah. There it begins. The devil is playing it too smart. We need to be careful. You can be friends. That's fine. But if something is cooking, something is fishy, it will smell. You need to know your boundaries. You need to know where to draw the lines. You understand what I'm trying to say? Right? If you enjoy, you know, coochie cooing, you know the meaning of that? Huh? Do you know the meaning of, you know, the touch and the sparks and the fire? Hello? Huh? You need to be touched. You need to be filled. You know, and so on and so forth. You want the makale? You want? Come here. Yeah, she's my girlfriend. Now, you become friends, and you can be friends. You know, that's fine. Slowly, you start gets closer, and then you get closer, and then you get more closer. That is dangerous. Set your boundaries. Thank you, Maklai. Here you go. Set your boundaries. If friendship design cheyan, you don't have to always hug and kiss and, you know, every time you meet, oh, baby, hug. That doesn't define your love. It defines your lust. Know what is love and lust. All right? If you are somebody who is lusting, when you get into an age where you get married and all, even then your life will be in doldrums. It's going to be tough for you. Discipline ourselves. It is very important. I've seen families shattering down. I've seen Pentecostal families, you know, in America, the number of divorces that happen in Pentecostal families are much greater than what is happening elsewhere. It is sad. As a pastor, it hurts me. You know why? Our children are not trained up properly in their schools, colleges, Sunday school teachers. Take time. Understand your kids. You know, when you see them different, talk to them, become friendly with them. You know, I still remember my Sunday school teachers. They were the first spiritual guides and parents who I had. I still remember them, thankfully. Right? You have to, ഈ സെൻട്രൽ സ്കൂളിൽ പഠിപ്പിക്കുക ഹിറ്റ് ആൻഡ് റൺ ഡോണ്ട് ഡു ദാറ്റ് ഓ ഐ ഹാവ് എ പോർഷൻ ടു ഫിനിഷ് ഐ കം സിറ്റ് റീഡ് ദിസ് ഇസ് ദ മെമ്മറി വേർഡ്സ് ദിസ് ഇസ് ദ സ്റ്റോറി ആൻഡ് ദിസ് ഇസ് മൈ സോങ് പ്രേസിങ് മൈ ഗോഡ് ഓൾ ദ ഡേ മൈ ലോങ് ബ്ലെസ്ഡ് അഷ്യൂറൻസ് ഡോണ്ട് ഡു ദാറ്റ് കം ടേക്ക് ടൈം സിറ്റ് വിത്ത് യുവർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ ഐ ഡോണ്ട് നോ ഹൗ മച്ച് ടൈം ഡു യു ഗെറ്റ് ഫോർ സൺഡേ സ്കൂൾ ഇൻ ദിസ് ചേർച്ച് ഐ ഡോണ്ട് നോ ദി വേ ഇറ്റ് വർക്ക്സ് ഹിയർ ഇറ്റ്സ് വെരി ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻറ്റ് ഫോർ എ സൺഡേ സ്കൂൾ ടീച്ചർ ടു അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ് യുവർ സ്റ്റുഡൻറ് Sit with them, talk to them, much more than the portions that you are teaching. If you see a girl sad, last week you saw her, she was cheerful, brightened. This Sunday you see her, she's sad. Talk to her. Makale enna pattiye. She may be waiting for that touch from you, you know. I'm telling you. She may be waiting to hear from you. Endo pattiyennu aarengilum chodikkanundo ennu വെയിറ്റ് ചെയ്യുന്ന പെൺകുഞ്ഞുങ്ങൾ കാണും ആസ് ദൻ ആർ കിഡ്സ് ആർ ഗേൾസ് ആർ പ്രഷ്യസ് ദ ആർ പ്രഷ്യസ് ടു ഗാഡ് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ദൈവം അവരെ സൺഡേ സ്കൂൾ ടീച്ചറായിട്ട് നിങ്ങളുടെ സ്റ്റുഡൻസായിട്ട് തന്നിട്ടുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ യു ആർ റെസ്പോൺസിബിൾ ടോക്ക് ടു ദം സ്പെൻഡ് ടൈം വിത്ത് ദം ടീച്ചേഴ്സ് എവറി ബോയ് എവറി ഗേൾ ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻ്റ് റൈറ്റ് ബി കെയർഫുൾ അബൌട്ട് യുവർ റിലേഷൻ ബി കെയർഫുൾ അബൌട്ട് വാട്ട് യു ടോക്ക് ബി കെയർഫുൾ അബൌട്ട് how you are going to lead your life. I'll stop here because I know the time is gone. But I wish, you know, we had more time to talk. I really wish we had more time to talk. Let me tell you one more thing and then I'll stop. Concerning your future, your choice of, you know, careers and your choice of education and all that. How do I do? What do I do? How do I know what is the right thing for me? How do I know? I wanted to become a doctor, honestly. I was okay in my education. Odappan ayirundengilum okay was, you know. I would study okay. Right? In my class we were 53 students. Now, you know, we have a group of all the 53 students from my school days. 23 of them are doctors. I also wanted to become a doctor. You know? But those were the times when capitation fee, getting into a college, you know, minus marking, you won't understand what I'm talking. It was so difficult. But God had a plan for me. When now I look back, I thank God that I did not become a doctor. Not that doctors are not good for God's ministry, not for me. Thank God that God had a different plan for me. How did I understand that? Growing up years, I had so much interest in reading the Bible. I had so much interest in souls. I had so much interest in, you know, in investing into young lives, talking to, even in school and colleges, I would spend time talking to youngsters. I knew where God was taking me into. Let me tell you, God will always give you signs of where He is taking you to. Did God give sign to Joseph where he was going to take him to? The path was difficult, right? It began with a dark pit. Your journey might start with a dark pit, but that dark pit is the first step for you where God is taking you to. Hello? Did you understand? You may not see anything. This dark pit Joseph is in, he doesn't understand. He thinks it's over. But that dark pit was the first step where God was taking him up to realize his dreams. So if you today don't know what is happening with you, if you today don't understand, you see everything dark, trust in the Lord. If God has given you a dream in the past, if God has given you, you know, a liking for an education, a career, stick to that. Because some of the things when you don't understand is when God is working behind the scenes for you. In the right time it will bud. In the right time it will unfold. In the right time you will see the fruits of it. Right? Trusting in the Lord. Now the word of God, I think it is in Proverbs, Proverbs chapter 9, I guess. It says, fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. Fear of the Lord. Now listen, have you seen the worldly people becoming big guys, big people in the world? Hello? Listen. All of you listen. Have you seen that? The people of the world, you know, every other person you see, they become big guys in the society. Their education, jobs, everything. But what is the word of God saying? Fear of the Lord is the beginning. Do you fear God? Do you fear God? So where is knowledge beginning? I want you to understand that word. Where is knowledge beginning? With you. With you. You are the most intelligent. You are the most, person with wisdom from above. If the people without fearing God, without wisdom from God, can achieve those heights, you who fear the Lord, what is the heights that you can reach? Think about it. You are special, people of God, children of God, young ones. You are special to the Lord. God has a plan. When God has a plan, all you need to do is give yourself into the hands of the Lord. Right? Let me say one or two things and then I'll stop here. This, I told you about the sheep. Let me talk about the coin. This coin is precious. Is it precious? Let me see if I have a... This is a rial that I have. Now, this is in my hand. Is it in my hand? I'm going to show you a trick, magic. Yeah. No, I don't know any magics. Now, listen. This, how many rials is this?
Oh.
All right. This 10 rial, who is the owner of it? Huh?
Oda.
No money. This is in my hand. It's mine, okay? I am the owner. Am I? Why? It's in my hand. I want you to listen. Right? It's in my hand. Okay? If it is crushed, sorry. If it is crushed, where is it? Where is it? I want you to speak. Where is it? Even in crushed stage, where is it? It's in my hand. As the owner of this cash, when I look at it, I see that it is crushed. What do? I don't like this condition. What do? I'll straighten it up. Right? Okay? So when you are in your owner's hand, even if when you are crushed, when he looks at you, he can fix you. Hello. All right? He can fix you. Second thing. This is in my hand, so I am the owner. It is mine. Now, if it is lost, then who does it belong to? It has an owner, but it is lost. In this lost situation. Now, let me ask you. When it was in my hand, it is in my hand. Does it have value? It is. It has value. When it is lost, does it have value? It still has value. But the one who understands the value is not with the thing which has a value. Did you get me? Hello. Did you understand what I'm trying to say? It still has value, but it is lost. Right? It is lost. But the moment the lost thing gets into my hand, right? It again has value. Why? In the lost stage, though it had value, it couldn't be used. Hello? Are you with me? But the moment it came into my hand, it has value and it can be used. You as a child of God, if you are lost, you may have value, but you cannot be used. Get into the hand of the owner who knows your value. He will use you. You may be crushed, right? When you are lost situation, people can tread upon you. They can walk upon you, right? They can kick you or anything. The wind may carry you. I do not know. In the lost condition is the worst phase of the life that you can be in. The moment you get into the one who knows you, values you, you can be used. Right? That is the reason this woman who understood the value. I do not want to get into the history and traditional cultural background behind the story. But young ones, for you to understand, this woman understood the value of the 10 coins. So now let me ask you, which has more value, 9 coins or 10 coins together? Now the 9 coins together has value, 1 coin and 9 coin. Which has value? The 9 coins together. But then this one is also added, it becomes more valuable. Right? Right? Hello? Right? All of you together, you are more valuable. Right? Don't throw away. Don't separate. Don't push. You don't belong here. You are not good. You are that. You are this. Don't set up those boundaries. You're all children of God. We are one family, wherever you may be. Hello, Mone. Good morning. Right? Orangalle gutta. Listen. There's important things I'm talking. Please don't. Right? You're precious. You're precious to God. Be together. If you have to forgive someone, just forgive. Now listen. If you cannot forgive, how can your God forgive you? Somebody would have hurt you. I can tell you stories in my life. But I still think. Sometimes I talk to my wife and say, "Enikku shemikkan pattadilla." You can ask her. But I forgive. I have to humble myself. Crush myself. It is tough for me to forgive some of the things that I have seen in my life. But for God to forgive a sinner like me, if God can forgive me, I have to forgive. Are you willing to forgive? Somebody would have hurt you. People would have hurt you. You might have been hurt by the words of others. You might have hurt by what others talk about you, your friends talk about you, you know, in your Sunday school, in your church, you know, some of the things that you did or said, people may have made fun about you, all those things. Those things have got into your heart and it has hurt you. But the moment you say, "God, I forgive," He's a God who is compassionate. He will also forgive you. But remember, unless you forgive, what a hypocrite I am that I'm asking for forgiveness. Can I ask for forgiveness unless I forgive? Some of us, you know, I have met youngsters, you know, who struggle to forgive their parents. Their parents have said something, their parents were strict, their parents disciplined them, and they cannot forgive their parents. That's a dangerous track that you are walking. It's not right. Forgive. Your pastor might have said something that has hurt you. Your peers would have said something which would have gone into your heart and it has hurt you. Forgive. It is important. All right? Last thing. Prodigal son. I told you, I'm just closing here, okay? First thing I told you, lost sheep. He couldn't walk his way back. Second thing, the lost sheep, a lost coin. It can't find its way back. The owner needs to find it up. But look at the son. What is he? He's got intelligence. He has got wisdom. Right? What can he do? The moment he understands his situation, he can walk back. Where? I wish I had time to, you know, take you to the passage. You know what this prodigal son says? When he came back to his senses, you need to know that scripture. I think it is 15, 16 somewhere. Chapter 15, 16, somewhere it says, you know, when the prodigal son came back to his senses, you know what he said? I will go back to? Pardon me? My father. Why didn't he say, "I will go back to my home"? Have you thought about it? Why did he say, "I will go back to my home"? Why did he say, "I will go back to my father"? I love that portion. You know why? Father will never judge him. He will not say, "Ella mudichalloda nee tirichendana vannai." But if he's going back home, his older brother is there. Ella medichundu poyadalle nee endana tirichu vannai. Lay. The servants are there. Oh, here comes the one who, you know, took away everything from his father. Look at this guy. He has no shame, embarrassment. He has come back. If he's coming back home, he can hear so many stories. What did he do? He came back to his father, from whom he took, is coming back to him. Why? He knew that his father is the sole authority. His father is the one who has authority at home. He came back to him. Right? When you come back to your father, he will not judge you. However, you know, bad you may have gone in your life, however filthy it may look like from the outside, but the moment you come back to your father, come back to your father will never judge you. You may have gotten into bad relations. You may have gone into pornography. You may have gone into sinful lusts. You may have gone into things that is not rightful with the Lord. But the moment you decide to come back to your father, God is willing to receive you. Will you take that walk back home today? If there is something that need to come back to, close your eyes. We're going to pray. എല്ലാവരും കണ്ണുകളെ ഒന്നടച്ച് നമുക്കൊരു നിമിഷം പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കാം. This is a very serious time, and I want you to take this time very seriously. I do not know what you have gone through. I do not know what is the hurts that you are carrying. I do not know what is your opinion about you, what others think about you. What is important is what God thinks about you. I do not know where you are lost. I do not know if you have strength to come back. But in that situation, if you are ready to walk back, your father is willing to receive you. Everyone close your eyes. Hallelujah. Pray for a minute. Everybody, pray for a minute. Ellavarum oru nimisham onnu prarthiche. Put your life before the Lord. He knows it. You can hide from people. You cannot hide from God. Let's confess. Say sorry. Forgive. Say, God, it's difficult for me to forgive, but I want to forgive because I want to receive forgiveness from you. I've heard those words which have hurt me. I've heard those things, O Lord, which has got into my life, which has stayed with me. Prarthiche makale. Ellavarum onnu prarthiche. പാടുന്നവരും മുമ്പോട്ടൊന്ന് വന്നേ. എല്ലാവരും ഒരു നിമിഷം ഒന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിച്ചേ. ഹല്ലേലൂയ. മക്കളെ, കണ്ണടയ്ക്ക്. ഐ ഡോണ്ട് വാണ്ട് എനിവൺ ടു ഓപ്പൺ യുവർ ഐസ്. എവ്രി ഐസ് ക്ലോസ്ഡ്. ലുക്ക് ടു ദ ലോർഡ് ഇൻ പ്രയർ. ദിസ് ഈസ് യുവർ ടൈം, യു നോ. സ്പെൻഡ് ടൈം വിത്ത് ഗോഡ്. ഐ ടോൾഡ് യു ദ സ്റ്റോറി അബൌട്ട് ദ ഷീപ്പ്. All it can do was cry, and it cried. And we know the moment the shepherd came, the shepherd took him over the shoulder. Namme nenjode cherkkunna devam, tholathettunna devam, evide edu ennu chodikkade nammude vedanakal arinju he understands us. People may have said stories about you. People might have spoken those words which has caused deep hurt inside you. I can sense in the spirit the Lord is ministering to you this day. Thank you, God. എല്ലാവരും ഒന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിച്ചേ. എല്ലാവരും ഒന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിച്ചേ. Surrender. படிக்க மக்களே படிக்க. Sing it again, all to Jesus.
All to Jesus.
Ellavarum onnu padike. Purama bashamana adharagadala shanthane.
Freely.
Things which are not pleasing to you. I've been hurt.
We praise you, Lord.
The words of people have hurt me. It's difficult for me to forgive. The words from my parents, my siblings, my church, my friends. I'm carrying so much of hurt, wounds inside me, God. But I surrender all of them to you this morning. Would you this morning take that step of faith and speak to the Lord and say, God, I surrender. Because I know you love me much more than anyone else. The cross was difficult for you. The agony was difficult for you. Golgotha was difficult for you. Calvary was difficult for you. The nails were difficult for you, God. The crown of thorns were difficult for you. But thank you that you love me so much, that you lavish your love upon me. Ella unforgiving spirit, യേശുവിന്റെ നാമത്തിൽ മാറിപ്പോകട്ടെ. ക്ഷമിക്കുവാൻ കഴിയാത്ത എല്ലാ അവസ്ഥകളും യേശുവിന്റെ നാമത്തിൽ മാറിപ്പോകട്ടെ. ഹല്ലേലൂയ. Lord, I pray your people, your children will be able to make strong decisions this afternoon, oh God. I pray for these young ones, oh God. I pray for their lives, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus. There's anything in their life, oh Lord, which is not pleasing in their sight.
Yes.
As they surrender their life to you this morning, I pray you have mercy on them. I pray you have mercy on them. How many of you want to surrender your life to the Lord this afternoon? Stand with me. Not all of you. If you want to rededicate your life, surrender your life, please stand with me. We will sing. Don't be ashamed. It is in the presence of God that you will be standing. If the Spirit of the Lord has ministered to you, talked to you, why are we looking here and there? Close your eyes. Pray. If the Spirit of the Lord is prompting,
Jesus, hallelujah,
would you stand with me? We will sing and we will worship the Lord.
We will pray together.
Come on, guys. Close your eyes.
Blessed Savior, I surrender all.
Shall you all stand? Shall we all stand together?
I surrender all.
Jesus, I surrender.
I surrender all.
Hallelujah.
I surrender all. I surrender all.
Holy Spirit, I pray.
All to Thee.
Touch Your children, O God.
Blessed
touch Your children, O God. Holy Spirit, I pray You minister to Your children, O God.
All to Thee, my blessed Savior.
Make a commitment this morning. Pray to the Lord.
I surrender all, Jesus. Hallelujah.
I surrender. I surrender. I surrender.
Jesus, come into Thy presence.
Bless them in Your name, O God.
I
bless this woman in Your name, O God. Shivana Namata.
Any grihing of it.
Shivana Mani grihing of it. Havi any grihing of it. Shivana Namata. Listen, listen.
All to Jesus I surrender.
All to Him I freely give.
All to Him I
make that commitment this afternoon.
I will never love
Jesus
when trust Him in His presence.
Sing it again.
All to Jesus I surrender. All to Him I
surrender. Devabha shamana daragadana shantana
Ishvara namata.
I bless Your children in Jesus' name. I pray for Your heavenly blessings to be upon them, O God. Bless them in Jesus' name.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Bless them in Jesus' name. Bless them in Jesus' name.
Surrender all, I surrender all.
Jesus,
sing it out loud.
Be my blessed Savior, all to Thee, my blessed.
Father God, we thank You for this day. Thank You for Your blessings, O God. Lord, I, Your servant, commit all these dear children into Your hands. They are precious in Your sight. They are precious in You, Lord. Lord, they are growing up years. Their school, their education, in church, at home, everywhere, wherever they are, I pray, Lord, that You will bless them. You will bless their going out and coming in. Hallelujah. Everything that they find to do, let Your favor be upon them, O God. Hallelujah. Lord, in this generation, in this wicked and perverse generation, we pray, Lord, that our children will lead a holy life. let their walk be before you. Every step that they take, let it be pleasing to you. Bless their future. Bless everything, O God. Let them have a blessed life in you, O God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All the hallelujah girls here, I pray, Lord, that you will minister to them with your grace, O God. The hurts that they have, the pains that they have, the struggles that they go through, you understand it. I pray, Lord, that you will minister to them. Oh, I commit all the boys into your hands. Bless their lives. Bless their future. Let them be found in you, O God. Thank you, Father God. I pray for the leadership here, the Sunday school, the teachers here, the headmaster, the associates, everyone of God, the pastor, the ministers, everyone of God. I commit all of them into your hands. I pray, Lord, that they will shine forth as bright light before you, O God. Candle in the darkness, shining forth for you, O God. Let the life be a blessing, O God. Thank you, Father God. Lord, I bless them in the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let them be blessed in you. Thank you for giving us this time. We give you glory in Jesus' precious name, we pray. Amen. Please be seated. God bless you all. Thank you. We just took some time, but I think you will forgive me for that. God bless you all. Thank you.